It is answer A. The mirror must be at least about half the size of Mrs. Santa. Let's imagine that the mirror hangs so that the top point of the mirror and the top point of Mrs. Santa are at the same height. A beam of light that emanates from Mrs. Santa's uppermost point, i.e. her head, can run horizontally to the uppermost of the mirror, is reflected back there, and finally falls into Mrs. Santa's eye. She can see herself up to the tips of her hair. A beam of light that emanates from the lowest point of Mrs. Santa, i.e. from her feet, can run at an angle to the lowest point of the mirror, where it is reflected back at the same angle. If this point is at half of Mrs. Santa's height, the beam of light on its way back to Mrs. Santa's feet can pass the same height again and fall into her eye. So she can also see her feet, and therefore her whole body. If you move the mirror forwards and backwards in your mind, the angle at which the lower light beam hits the mirror and is reflected back changes. However, the fact that Mrs. Santa can see herself from head to toe, or rather the part of the image visible to her, remains unchanged. This relationship is described by the so-called intercept theorem. Do some research on the internet.